Hello guys and welcome to Python programming tutorials by Amul's Academy. In the previous class we discussed about the selection control statements. Today in this tutorial we are discussing about the iterative control statements. These iterative control statements repeatedly execute the instruction, so these are also referred as loops. That is, this for statement is also called as for loop and this while statement is also called as while loop. Okay, first we'll discuss about the for loop. Now we'll see the syntax of for loop. For that, first we need to mention the keyword for, then space, next variable. This is also called as iterative variable, that is the variables which are used in this process. Next, the membership operator in sequence. Here sequence is nothing but it can be list or strings. Strings are nothing but the values which are enclosed within the single quotes or double quotes, and list is the group of different types of values. Now colon. Here we can perform the action. Example for loop. Okay. So I'll use for. Now we need to use one variable. I'll use as letter and membership operator in. Now I'll use string here, that is Python colon. Now print character is comma letter. We'll save this, we'll run this. You can see character is P, character is Y, character is T, character is H, character is O, character is N. As I said, for is an iterative control statement, that is this will execute the instruction repeatedly. Okay, in this case letter is a variable. Here the first character will be assigned to the variable letter, so letter is equal to P. Now it will execute the statement. Again the control goes to the for loop, and now letter is Y, so it will execute the statement. Again the control goes to the for, letter will assign with the T, so it will print T. Next again it will go to the for loop, and now it is H, then O, then N. Okay, here the first character will be assigned to the variable, that is letter will hold the character P, it will execute the statement. The control again goes to the for loop, and now the next character will be assigned to the variable, that is Y, again it will execute the statement, and again control goes to the for loop. It continues until the last character. We'll take another example. We'll use list here, that is 10 20 30 40, print letter. Okay, now I'll save this, run this. We can see the output 10 20 30 40. First, the first item will be assigned to the variable letter, so it will print the value 10. Next, control again goes to the for loop, then now the next item will be assigned to the letter, so it will print value 20. Next, again control goes to the for loop, now the value assigned to the letter is 30, so it will print 30. Next, again control goes to the for loop, and now letter value is 40, so it will print 40. And again control goes to the for loop, but there are no other element is present, so it will terminate the loop. Okay, this is about the for loop. We can use if else statement or if statement within the for loop. That is, here I'll use if statement. Okay, if letter is greater than or equal to 25. Okay, I'll print. Letter, comma, greater than 25, or else print letter less than 25. I'll save this and run this. Now we can see 10 is less than 25, 20 is less than 25, 30 is greater than 25, and 40 is greater than 25. In this programming example, there is a group of elements, that is 10, 20, 30, 40. In the if statement, we checked whether the value is greater than or equal to 25. If it is greater than or equal to 25, then we printed this message. If it is not, then we go for the else part. Okay, this is about the for loop in Python programming language. Thank you for watching. I'll meet you in next class. Till then, take care.